Live and on demand from the WNY News Now studios in downtown Jamestown, this is News Now at Noon.
And thanks for joining us for News Now at Noon. I'm Justin Gould.
And I'm Matt Hummel. Now at noon, at long last, the South Main Street Bridge is slated to reopen here in the city of Jamestown tomorrow.
Plus, Jamestown Police has reopened their lobby area to the public. We speak with Police Chief Harry Snellings in just a few. But first, we check in with Chief Forecaster Dakota Hunter, who's standing by in the First Defense Weather Center. Happy Tuesday, Dakota.
Happy Tuesday, Jay and Matt. And oh boy, we've got some more snow on the way. So let's take a look at it here. So first of all, the National Weather Service has issued a winter weather advisory for much of Western New York. You can see here, this is for the southern tier. This starts tomorrow morning and lasts until 4 p.m. on tomorrow. And there's actually one that goes for Buffalo that goes until 10 a.m. tomorrow. But our focus is going to be the winter weather advisory for the southern tier. And this is for lake effect snow that's going to set up tonight and then lasting through tomorrow. As we take a look at First Defense Doppler, you can see we've had widespread snow showers working its way through the area. There's a little bit of connection to the lake here, but this actually isn't our main concern. Our main concern is what comes tomorrow. And the snow has been kind of a steady state throughout the morning. And the NOAA Climate Prediction Center updated the 6 to 10 day temperature outlook. And we are in this gray area, which means equal chances, which basically means a 50-50 chance of seeing above or below average temperatures over the next 6 to 10 days. And when I show you the 7 day a little bit later on, you'll kind of see why they're in a little bit of a hem haul about that. So hour by hour for today, temperatures, it looks like we're going to hit 33 early, and then the temperatures are going to fall down into the 20s as we go to the nighttime hours here, with a chance for a few snow showers. Lake effect snow gets going tomorrow, and we'll talk about that. Plus Thanksgiving, how chilly in a little bit. J-Matt.
Dakota, thank you for the hem haw. And again, at long last, the South Main Street Bridge in the city of Jamestown will reopen. The Chautauqua County Public Facilities Director, Brad Bentley, says the bridge will reopen tomorrow. He sends his thanks to those involved in the project, especially as the weather started to turn. Bentley says the top asphalt layer won't be constructed until the spring due to the weather. Bridge wall capstone and pavement lane markings will be installed before the 30th. The county also says that two bridges on Poland Center Road are set to reopen tomorrow.
Oh, good to hear. That South Main Street Bridge project has been a little crazy for a lot of people waiting for quite some time, you know, down to one lane and then finally shut it down all the way. So it's good to see that traffic will be flowing once again.
You know what that means. We don't have to take as long to go to Tim Hortons.
Hey, that's even better. It's only a 2-minute drive from our downtown city instead of 5, you know. Forbid that we can't get the coffee. So saying hello to Robert. Good Tuesday to you, sir. Thanks so much for joining us. Hello to Pam and to Andrew as well. So much here to talk about. Another big story from last night. One of the largest centers for reading and information here in the city of Jamestown is in need of help. And they reached out to the city council last night. Library Executive Director Tina Scott from the Prendergast Library asked council members Monday night to increase funding in the city's 2019 budget from $50,000 to $100,000. Now, last year, the library's funding was cut in half. In 2016, the budget was cut from $350,000 to $100,000. Scott said in order to continue to provide needed resources for the city of Jamestown, the library needs to find some sort of sustainable income.
Obviously, the library is just a natural place to go, and it's welcoming to everybody. So I can't imagine that we won't at some point be successful in getting some type of sustainable funding. We've done our part. We've really cut back. So we're doing everything we can to remain open so that we can continue to be a library, because we have to be open 55 hours a week in order to even be a library, not just a central library of the library system. We have to be open 55 hours because we are in a community over 30,000.
Now, Scott said so far the library is operating on a skeleton crew, relying on future fundraisers to keep the lights on. City Councilman Andrew Liuzzo spoke last night to Scott, saying he'd like to help, but the city has budget problems of its own.
There is no money. If we develop economic development, which we've heard tonight that there's a lot of plans, if we can get the tax base increased. People complaining about another tax, you can't blame them, because this year we had a lot of things done on the streets, but there was a lot of years that nothing was done. And where is the tax money going? Well, the tax money is going to pay expenses that were out of our control, that we have, we can't rein in. It's the same story. So until we can get the city on a better financial, stable foundation, everybody's going to suffer. Everything that we support is going to suffer.
Now, this is the third year Scott has asked council members to help with library funding. And Matt, you know, this is a huge story that is not over yet. And the city of Jamestown's Prendergast Library has a ton of services. Speaking with Scott last night, we couldn't fit it all into this report. But, you know, from the computers they use to helping people learn English who are coming to the city to almost like a not quite daycare facility. Obviously, you can't leave your child there. But children who are old enough to be on their own go to the library to seek refuge. And it's a huge hub for the city of Jamestown. Obviously, it seems like a lot of people want the library to stay. But unfortunately, there's not too much that can be done from the city's point, since they have their own budget woes.
Well, we've covered the library situation, I think, since our birth.
Right.
Like, birth of the organization here.
Right. And it's been very much ongoing.
And we could just feel the emotions every time there's a public forum where they have this discussion. There are a lot of people that, you know, they rely on the library. And it's not just about, you know, financial gains. It's about the sanctity of the place. You have the books, you have the quiet zone. And there's so much. I mean, this is something that is, I think will probably continue to be ongoing. And, you know, I really hope that it works out, you know, for all sides involved.
Right.
Because, you know, again, a lot of emotions are here on the line.
Right, absolutely.
Well, in the meantime, the Jamestown Police Department reopened its East 2nd Street headquarters to the public this morning after flooding issues plagued the office for over a year. Jamestown Police Chief Harry Snellings says the reopening is a long time coming, and now the public can contact police directly by walking through the door.
Now the community will have more direct access. Before it was a process, they had to call, come in through City Hall. We had to send officers upstairs to meet with them and took them down into some makeshift facilities. And so now it'll be full access to the police department again. You know, our appreciation to the community for their patience. And also I want to convey that our officers, they were very patient in having to deal in those conditions and help make that transition. And so we really didn't miss a beat for the last year, but we're all excited that we can open the doors again.
Now, Snelling said the police's drug drop box is also now available once again.
And that's great, because a lot of people, you know, it was a process, even for us, to go in and interview police about stories that were ongoing. You know, we'd have to meet them at a side door and come in. Mm-hmm. So it's really good. And Snellings and I talked last night, also, you know, at that meeting, that's where that soundbite came from, you know, about the fact that this is good, because now the public finally can get back in there and talk to officers one-on-one rather than having to call through the phone.
So. I mean, and you and I think, went in there last year. It was such a mess.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
like,
yeah.
To see the,
and
you
I
know,
mean, if we can roll that video again, mm-hmm. I mean, this is file footage of 2017, the day that they announced that they had the flooding issues. I mean, and this is, like, immediately afterwards, mm-hmm. but it was a mess. And even continuing forward, and obviously the City Hall building, you know, they worked really hard to get that cleaned up, and, you know, things don't just happen overnight, so it's good that they have a nice area back open, kind of how it was, so really good to see here. Next, so much more to tell you about. A former Chautauqua County clerk has passed away. Details on that in just a bit.
And later, a 99-year-old woman is back out on the roads of Jamestown. Stay tuned for more.
Stop stop by the Jamestown Cycle Shop Super Sale and get super savings. Shop local on Black Friday and Small Business Saturday. Visit us at 10 Harrison Street and save big. Purchase any backpack, duffel, team, or travel bag for $30, then fill the bag with goodies in the store. Head to checkout and anything that fits in the bag is 50% off. Spend at least $200 and you get a $25 gift card. It's a super sale. Friday and Saturday, 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. at the Jamestown Cycle Shop.
EagleZip.com is your local one-stop shop for all of your home and business computer needs. Located on Fluvanna Avenue Extension, just outside of Jamestown, EagleZip.com sells and services all brands of desktops and laptops, as well as servers and network equipment for your business. All new computer sales include transferring your data from your old computer plus a two-year warranty. Call EagleZip.com today.
Stop by EagleZip.com today and let us make computers easy for you.
With coverage that matters. This is WNY News Now.
A former Chautauqua County clerk has passed away. 90-year-old Henry Weiler died Sunday in his Lakewood home. Weiler served as clerk from 1986 to 1983. He also worked in the county's Supreme Court chambers as part of the 8th Judicial District. A service will be held at the Lakewood United Methodist Church on Saturday at 3 p.m.
And Governor Andrew Cuomo recently announced that he'd sign into law a bill that will be considered next year that would allow illegal immigrants to apply for a driver's license. Congressman Tom Reed called out that idea, saying it was extreme, and he said that the bill wouldn't solve the problem.
I believe the better approach is not by granting illegal immigrant driver's licenses, which is a band-aid to this situation and rewards illegal behavior at the expense of those that came here illegally and followed the rule, and also potentially puts at risk law enforcement officials, because as we have seen with the MS-13 situation and people that are coming here to do bad things, to give them some sort of a driver's license that law enforcement would not be able to know who they were dealing with, puts at risk not only our law enforcement folks, but our fellow American citizens. By taking a tool out of the toolbox, law enforcement would have to know who they were dealing with if they came across an illegal immigrant.
Now, Reed said he hopes that Cuomo will reconsider his position, and he's urging his office to come together to find a solution for immigration.
The Chautauqua, Cattaraugus, Allegheny, and Steuben's Southern Tier Extension Railroad Authority, Justin, will receive $1.3 million for track rehabilitation and grade cross improvements from Steinberg to Poland Center. The grant is part of a $27.1 million initiative announced by Governor Cuomo to fund rail and port improvement projects throughout the state. Cuomo says the rail and port infrastructure is key to local economies across the state, particularly as businesses continue to grow and develop.
And really, Matt, this is very interesting. Obviously, this part of the railroad is in pretty rural areas, but I know they were talking about with the National Comedy Center that they wanted to use the rail to help bring people into Chautauqua County. Mm-hmm. We haven't really seen any announcements on that development yet. I know a lot of attention shifted to the airport with trying to bring people. Obviously, one of the best ways to get around here is by vehicle. They say if you don't have a vehicle in this area, you really can't get around too much. Yep. Because there is no regional transportation. There's carts and things like that. But that really cool that they're upgrading and looking into trying to improve the railroad situation. I'm sure that the tracks are getting old, because Rory and I were talking in the newsroom about this story. You know, steam trains used to run on those lines.
Really?
Yeah. So it's really old, old system.
We're looking far back.
Right. So you know, nice to see that they're working on that, and we'll of course keep in tune to all of that news.
And Governor Cuomo, he's had a busy few days.
Yes,
we saw in that last story as well.
Edwin says, we honestly don't care about Cuomo, JPD opening to the public. Just get that bridge done. Exactly. That's what a lot of people, I agree with you there, Edwin, to the point where the bridge is another huge story for the city of Jamestown. You know, it's been closed for years, really.
I mean, I think it all started in 2014?
Yeah, is when it all started, and you know, a lot of people were very frustrated when it went down to one lane because that really slowed things down. And then things were just shut down when they completely closed it. So good to see that that's reopening tomorrow. We kind of jokingly said it's nice to have a direct route to Tim Hortons. Next here, Chief Forecaster Dakota Hunter with an update on our 7-day forecast. How cold will it get this Thanksgiving?
And later, hear how a City of Jamestown woman gets her license back at age 99. Wow. After this, wow.
Keep your car running smooth this winter at Express Bike and Auto, located at 1761 Foot Avenue Extension, right here in Jamestown. They're your one-stop shop for all of your automotive needs. Looking for a new ride? Express Bike and Auto even sells vehicles. And guess what? Financing is available. What are you waiting for? Visit Express Bike and Auto at 1761 Foot Avenue Extension today.
Coming soon to downtown Jamestown, Pearl City Hops Restaurant and Tavern. The full-service restaurant will carry a wide array of craft brews, wines, and food pairings to make your taste buds sing. Enjoy breakfast, lunch, and dinner 7 days a week, including a Sunday brunch buffet. A truly one-of-a-kind experience coming soon.
You're watching WNY News Now, where coverage comes first. First Defense Weather is sponsored by Quick Solutions of Jamestown. Count on Quick Solutions for printing, copying, mass mailings, and so much more. Part of your team. Learn more at QuickSolutionsUSA.com. That's QuickSolutionsUSA.com. First Defense Weather, the Southern Tier's only live and local weather source. Now, here's Chief Forecaster Dakota Hunter.
Hey, welcome back to News Now at Noon on this snowy Tuesday. As we take a look at the Sky Vision Camera Network, this is coming from the Mill Creek Mall, an area you can kind of see at times the snowflakes falling as well. 35 with a northwest wind to 6, and of course that northwest wind is keeping us just a little bit cooler than we should be this time of the year. Once again, there is a winter weather advisory for lake effect snow. This goes in effect tomorrow morning and lasts until 4 p.m. tomorrow for everybody in the Southern Tier minus Allegheny County. And this is for a band of lake effect snow that's going to set up late tonight and then lasting through tomorrow. And so here comes the first defense on all the data you need to know on that. So again, the band will set up tonight, lasting through tomorrow, and the band will mainly focus on the Southern Tier, but there will be a little bit of a northward jog, hence the reason why that winter weather advisory is also in effect for the Buffalo Metro. But how much snow are we talking about here? Maybe 3 to 6 inches out of that, and again, the highest chance for 6 inches is going to be right along the hills. And hazardous travel is definitely possible from blowing snow, wind gusts maybe of around 35 miles an hour, so just keep an eye on that if you're traveling. News Now Cam, you can see the snow falling here in downtown Jamestown. 32 is the current temp with a northwest wind to 8, and you got your wind chill of 25, and that wind chill number, hey, UPS guy, how you doing? That's not UPS, that's the post office guy, same thing. The packages always are late. But still, the packages are always delivered late. Doesn't matter. 35 degrees is the wind chill there. This is the first front that's coming through now. This is the second front that's going to come through tomorrow. Behind that, high pressure is going to build in, and that's going to continue through Thanksgiving Day. Zooming in on First Defense Doppler, you can see this band of snow that has been moving through. There's a little bit more rain mixed into it right along the Lake Erie shoreline, and that's part of the reason why the snowfall amounts near the Lake Erie shoreline are not going to be as high, because there's going to be more rain mixing in. And now, even though this is kind of measuring the fog, this actually isn't fog. What this is the snow that's being blown around. 1 mile visibility in Jamestown, 2.5 in Dunkirk, and 1.5 in Olean. This really isn't fog as much as it is the snow being whipped around by the wind. So here we go with Future Scan. You can see the model picks up on that snow today. Backs off tonight. There's that lake effect band. It starts to get going northward, and it quickly works its way to the south and settles down into the southern tier. Again, the darker blues indicate the heavier amounts of snowfall rates, and then it'll ultimately stag further southward and then fall apart. This is a weak little band of Lake Ontario lake effect that may impact the Buffalo Metro and parts of the southern tier tomorrow afternoon. So here are the projected snowfall amounts. Again, maybe 3-4 inches. The better chance for 5 or 6 is going to be right along the Boston Hills, right along the Chautauqua Ridge. That's going to be the highest chance for 5 or 6 inches tomorrow. So mostly not a big deal from that. And Thanksgiving's going to be cold. This is the second front that's going to come on through, and high pressure builds in. But as I told you yesterday, instead of high pressure from the south, it's going to come in from the northwest, and that's going to bring north, and that's going to bring a northerly wind in, and northerly wind means cold air. And you can see that here. The computer is spitting out a high of around 19. We're going to struggle to hit 20. And look at this as we go into Thursday night. 8. Yeah, it's going to be chilly. For tonight, though, partly to mostly cloudy. Lake effect snow sets up by morning, 24 to 29, with a northwest wind of around 6 to 14 miles per hour. You got them. Oh, baby, there's the next 7 days. 32 on Wednesday, and there's that front. We're going to be into the teens Thursday morning and not even making it out of the teens for Thanksgiving Day. But hey, rebound. The 40s come back for the weekend and early next week. Sports is next. Stay right.
Fire is so delightful. Since there's no place to go, let us know, let us know, let us know.
The Fitness Bunker in Lakewood is a locally owned and operated club that cares about your health and wellness. They invest in it. Right now, enter their 30-day challenge, where for only $69, you get 30 days of unlimited everything. That's right, everything, along with 2 one-on-one personal training sessions. Then, if you lose 10 pounds, you'll get the next month free. Plus, the first place winner will get 2 Buffalo Bills tickets or a $100 gift card. Details right now on the Fitness Bunker's Facebook page.
I just love to be with the dogs, and I like to do them one at a time. They don't wait for 5 hours in my shop. We have full groom, which includes everything from A to Z, nails, of course, brushing, any trimming that needs to be done. I do offer teeth brushing, which is a little extra. So if he takes me 2 hours, it's $40. If he takes me 3 hours, I still keep it down. As long as the dog comes back happy and not at the door, I'm happy.
You're watching WNY News Now, your source for breaking news. WNY Sports Now is powered by Phone Zone of Jamestown. With the largest inventory around, we buy and sell our own merchandise at a price that can't be beat. Have a broken screen? We'll fix it. Learn more at PhoneZoneShop.com.
Happy Tuesday, sports fans. And welcome back to News Now at Noon. I'm Norm Rodriguez with a look at sports. This afternoon, the Washington Middle School girls basketball team will be hosting Jefferson Middle School. It will be the last game before Thanksgiving break. Tip-off will be at 4:30. The Buffalo Sabres extended their winning streak to 6 games after coming back from a 3-goal deficit to defeat the Penguins 5-4 in overtime Monday night. With the win, the Sabres remain in third place in the Eastern Conference with 28 points, 1 point behind the second place Lightning. Buffalo's next game will be tomorrow night at the KeyBank Center against the Flyers. Puck drop will be at 7:30. Tonight at 7:30, the 7-10 Brooklyn Nets will be hosting the 6-10 Miami Heat. The Nets lost to the Clippers 127-119 last Saturday. Miami has lost their last 2 games. The game will be televised on YES and Fox Sports South. Fans can also watch the game on the NBA app. Justin and Matt, back to you.
Awesome. Normo Stormo, thank you very much. I'm Matt Hummel's not too happy about that Penguins score.
Of course
but,
not.
Yeah, he'll live with it. This is a great story. A 99-year-old Jamestown woman is now back behind the wheel after getting her license revoked over the summer. Kelsey Anderson from our news partner, News 4, explains in this special report.
Millie Wheelock uses her car most days of the week.
My errands. I do all my errands.
And at the end of June, she says she was parked on the road outside the grocery store when she was hit from behind.
It didn't hurt me any, but it jarred me so bad that I thought I was going to faint or do something. So I sat down, and I guess that's where they got the idea that I was not well.
A few weeks later, Millie said she got a note in the mail saying her license was revoked due to poor health.
I couldn't believe that they would do it to me. And I did go to my doctor, and she said I'm in perfect health.
The only way to get the license back was to take a driver's test, something she hadn't done since she was 17 years old. So she came here, advanced driver training in Jamestown.
All of a sudden, this little lady walks in my door, and I go, oh, this must be Sophia from the Golden Girls.
That's Bob Trescari, the owner of the driving school. The oldest student he had before Millie was 91, but he made it his goal to help her get that license back.
You want me to...
Nope, you're good right there.
The two did about 10 lessons together, and they had a lot of fun.
She didn't know how to parallel park. She didn't know how to three-point turn, but she was great on the road.
He was so good to me. And he's such a good teacher.
And finally, on November 14th, it was time to take the big test.
And I didn't know which way it was going to go, good, bad. And I saw her hands go up and she went like this. And I started crying. Sorry. And I was so happy for her.
At 99 years old, Millie Wheelock passed her road test.
No mustard, no mayonnaise.
And her advice for others, no matter your age, no matter the roadblock, you can achieve so much if you put your heart and a little gas into it.
If it's in your mind, go ahead and do it. Anything that I feel like doing, I do. I don't worry about my age at all because I just never have.
She's got a good sense about her.
Again, that's Kelsey Anderson with News 4 in Buffalo reporting. Wheelock said the 82 years she's had her license, she only had one parking ticket. And guys, I just want to say, I want to thank News 4 for that report. And I want to thank Millie because I know her personally. One of my mom's very good friends was in high school. That is her grandmother. And sweetest little old lady we meet once a year when Robin comes back to the area. We have lunch with her, and it's so incredible to see her. And, you know, she's awesome. And I'm glad that she's able to be back on the roadway because for her age at 99, super intelligent, guys. Like, all of it's right there.
I can see that.
Yeah, very much. Mm-hmm. I mean, I would consider her to be almost like a mind of a 50-year-old. I really would. So it's incredible.
I love that Sophia from the Golden Girls line. That was hilarious. I like that.
It was pretty good. Rory chiming in here, he says, Bob Trescari is a good
Norm.
Man. Norm, I'm sorry. Bob Trescari is a good man. Help me get my license. So indeed, and you know, that's like the super sweet stories of the city of Jamestown is you always have something like that. And, you know, it takes a different perspective to try to see those. So we really appreciate that. Final moments here. Want to get a final check of the weather here with Dakota Hunter.
So first of all, let's talk about the Thanksgiving Day forecast very quickly here. And now, as I've been talking about all week, it is going to be cold. Take a look at this. 16 to 21 is the high temp range for Thanksgiving Day. We're going to struggle to hit 20 in the city of Jamestown, so it's going to be very, very cold. But hey, at least it's going to be partly to mostly sunny. That's good, but that northerly wind is going to keep us cool. And the 40s return for the weekend into early next week. Chance for a few rain and snow showers at that point.
Awesome. Cool. Thanks, Dakota.
Welcome.
Hey, that's it for us today. Another live look here at the HD News Now cam. People may be slipping and sliding out there. Watch out for black ice, because I know our parking lot, guys, was a little slick when we came in this morning. So just be careful out there. We are back tomorrow with a Wednesday edition of News Now at noon. We'll see you then. Fun the women take. You walk past and I go crazy.